Good morning, children. Hope you are fine. Children, please take out your literature book, chapter 4, The Parrot Who Would Not Talk. Are you ready with the lesson, children? Let's start. Let's read a story about a parrot that was not quite like other parrots. So this is a story about a parrot who was not willing to talk, who did not want to talk. When I was growing up in Missouri, almost everyone kept a pet parrot or parakeet. Sometimes these birds became great talkers. They would say things like, "Study, child, study," or "Don't be greedy, don't be greedy." These words were picked up by the bird after some members of the household had repeated them many times in front of him. But our parrot refused to talk. So children, here the speaker lived in Missouri. It is the name of the place. And in Missouri, everyone kept a parrot as a pet. And children, we know that parrots are great talkers. And they learn to talk from the other members who live in the house. But the speaker's parrot refused to talk. You know what is the meaning of refused? Refused means not willing to talk. He had been bought by Aunt Ruby from a bird catcher who had visited all the houses on our road. Granny and grandfather were not keen on keeping a caged bird as a pet, but Aunt Ruby insisted. So, this parrot was bought by Aunt Ruby. Aunt Ruby is the speaker's aunt from a bird catcher. You know what is the meaning of bird catcher? Bird catcher means those who catches bird. Okay, so this parrot was bought by Aunt Ruby from a bird catcher. But Granny and grandfather, they were not interested to keep a bird in a cage as a pet. Maybe it is a sin. Okay. But Aunt Ruby did not listen. So she bought the parrot and tried to teach him to talk. But the parrot did not like her at all. Now Aunt Ruby, she tried to teach the bird to speak, to talk. But the parrot did not like her at all. "Kiss, kiss," she would say, putting her face close to the bars of the cage. But the parrot would back away with anger. She used to say, "Kiss, kiss," okay, putting her face close to the bars of the cage. But the parrot did not like her at all. One day, the parrot suddenly dived forward and knocked Aunt Ruby's spectacles off her nose. After that, she did not like the parrot anymore. She started making faces at him and calling out, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance." Children, knocked means struck. Spectacles means glasses, chashma. Okay. Now, what happened that one day the parrot suddenly came forward, means close, and struck Aunt Ruby's spectacles from her nose. Aunt Ruby got hurt. She was very angry. And from that day, she did not like the parrot anymore. She hated him and started making faces at him and started calling him, "You are useless, cannot talk, cannot sing, cannot dance." Grandmother then put me in charge of feeding the parrot. He was quite happy to take the green chilies and ripe tomatoes from my hands. I also gave him slices of mango. This gave me the chance to eat a few mangoes myself. Now, what happened? After that, grandmother put the speaker in charge of feeding the parrot. Okay, so grandmother told the speaker to take care of the parrot. The parrot liked his master. He loved to take green chilies and ripe tomatoes from his hands. He gave him slices of mango and he also used to eat mangoes. One afternoon, while everyone was in the dining room, I gave the parrot his lunch. By mistake, I left the cage open. Seconds later, the bird was winging its way into the freedom of the mango orchard. Now, what happened? One afternoon, while everyone was in the dining room, he gave the parrot his lunch. And by mistake, you know what happened? He left the cage open. And the bird flew away from the cage. At the same time, grandfather came onto the veranda and remarked, "I see your aunt's parrot has escaped." So grandfather said that he saw the parrot, aunt's parrot has escaped. Okay, escaped means ran away. The door was quite loose, I said with a shrug. Okay, now speaker was very upset, very ashamed, very guilty, saying that the door was quite loose. Aunt Ruby was upset. "I thought we would never see the parrot again. But a few days later, I found the bird sitting on the veranda railing. Unselfishly, I gave the parrot half of my mango." So Aunt Ruby was very sad, okay, upset. And the speaker is saying that he would never see the parrot again. But you know what happened? After a few days, he found the bird sitting on the veranda railing. And unselfishly, he gave the parrot half of his mango. While the bird was enjoying the mango, Aunt Ruby came out of her room and cried out, "Look, there is my parrot. He must have missed me." Now, what happened? The parrot was enjoying the mango, okay, on that veranda railing. Aunt Ruby came out of her room. Aunt Ruby saw the parrot and cried, shouted, "See, there is my parrot. He has missed me." With a loud squawk, the parrot flew out of her reach and perched on the nearest rose bush. He glared at Aunt Ruby and screamed at her in my aunt's familiar tones. "You are useless. Can't talk, can't sing, can't dance." Children, squawk means a loud noise made by a bird. Glared means looked. Screamed means shouted. Okay, so the bird made a loud sound and flew to the nearest rose bush. He glared at Aunt Ruby, means he looked at Aunt Ruby and shouted at her in her familiar tones, saying, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance." Aunt Ruby went ruby red and ran inside her room, means Aunt Ruby got very angry. Ruby red means very angry, got ruby red and ran inside her room. But that wasn't the end. The parrot became a regular visitor to the garden and veranda. Okay, so the parrot every day he used to visit to the garden and veranda. And whenever it saw Aunt Ruby, it would say, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing and can't dance." Children, so finally the parrot had learned to talk. Now children, listen carefully. Read the lesson very carefully. Learn the spellings, the new words, the difficult words, you learn it. The word meanings which are given below, you learn it. Okay, and when we will meet in the next class, we will discuss the question answers. You just find out the question answers and write in the rough copy. And when we will meet, we will discuss the question answers. Thank you, children.